Hi guys, so today we're going to do another little beach scene just on your other little square canvas. So the first few colours we're going to use are our cerulean blue and cobalt blue. So number 13 and number 11. Just pop them in your palette. We're going to start with brush number 6. So your medium flat brush. I'm kind of mixing the two colours. And we're just going to go a third down the page. So one, two, three, we're going to start around here. And just go kind of in a line across, creating a horizon of the sea. You can go over the edges as well, just on the sides. And we're just going to go down about a third as well of the page. So we'll have a third will be our sky, a third will be our sea, roughly. Might come up a little bit there. And you can dip your paintbrush into the water if you're struggling to move the paint. It just loosens it up a little bit, makes it easier to move. And you just want to keep doing strokes over and back. And you can have little variations of each colour as well, that's absolutely fine. The sea isn't all one block of colour anyway. Two around there as well. Your little side bits again. And the bottom line, the bottom part doesn't have to be perfect, because it's like the sea is coming in anyway. So an off-center line is fine. Then we're going to work on our sky area, so we're just going to need a little bit of white. And even with the blue you've got already, put the white in a separate pot. And we'll just make a lighter version of our white. So you just add a little bit of the blue in with the white, and you should get a nice sort of a sky blue. Keep dipping in the water if you need a little bit. And just fill up this space up here. And please pause the video if you need to take a few minutes just to do catch up. I'm going to be going through this quite quickly, so you can take your time. Don't worry if there's lighter and darker bits on that. Kind of adds to the sky. Nice. I'm still using the same kind of wide square brush. Just softly over back. And you can do those little side bits as well. Work the white back into there. It's kind of nice to fill in the edges. So you can see the nice little kind of contrast there. And with some of the leftover sky white, you can actually just work that into the bottom parts here. Almost like it's the waves coming in. A little bit of water as well, just to soften it. It kind of looks like the water is just lapping in. I'm going to swap brushes. I'm actually going to go for this slightly smaller, softer, rounder brush, and I'm going to make up a colour for some sand. So for this one, we're going to use a little bit of raw umber. So it's number 22 in this little pack. And just into a clean pot, a little bit of that, and a good bit of white. Now you can put the white into a separate other pot. And we'll just slowly add in the brown, so the burnt, the raw umber. So get a little bit of water, mix up your raw umber, and then slowly add that in. Now we might want to warm it up slightly, so we'll add a tiny bit of the yellow ochre, tiny, tiny, because it's a very strong colour. So dip into the water again. A little bit of yellow ochre, and then mix that in with your white. Can actually go a little bit more, just till you get a nice kind of sandy looking colour. Everyone's can be different, which is totally fine. A little bit more water. And then you just want to start building up this bottom area. Again, this doesn't always all have to be a black colour either. Go kind of softly into where the water is though. Just kind of softly in there. It looks like the water is overlapping. And again, you can paint your little side parts. Kind of harder to pick up now, but this looks nice and finished at the end. Building up that sandy area. Now the next colour we want to use is a nice green colour. So you want to start with your sap green. So again, just pop that out onto your palette. And we're going to go for our skinny brush. So a nice thin brush, a liner brush. And you can dip that into the water, into your green again. We want it to be kind of watery, just so it's easy to move. What we're going to do is just create a few little leafy areas. So again, just take your time with this. I'm going much quicker than you need to. You can just pause the video and go back. So these are just kind of the rushes on the beach. You can kind of do these wherever you fancy. I'm going to try and balance it a little bit, so I'll put them on both sides. I'm just slowly adding them in. It can be all different shapes and sizes. I'm just using an up and down motion. Add a little bit more water in if you need to. Maybe there's a few smaller ones as well on their own. Kind of blends in with the sand colour actually, so it's kind of nice. Then you can start to add some thicker kind of areas or slightly darker. No, it might be nice. You know, you have this lovely dark brown colour that we use to create a bit of the sand. Get some of that brown into a new pot and add in some of the green. They'll need a little bit of water to mix those, but should give you just a darker, kind of a deeper green. It's kind of nice, just add those in. So it'll give it a little bit of depth. And you can just scatter those on either side. You can kind of see there, it's just giving a little bit of depth, a little bit of light and shade. So it's nice. And then you can go in with a little bit of your actual brown. Don't go too mad with the brown, but you can water it down a little bit and just add a few hints of that there. Just creates a bit of light and shade. I don't know if you can see that well, but you'll be able to see it when you do it yourself. Just little bits here and there. You want to get one of your a darker blue, so I'm going to try the ultramarine violet, which is kind of a purpley color. Actually, no, ultramarine blue. Let's try that one. It's a bit of a darker blue. And we'll try the ultramarine violet as well, just a little bit, kind of a purple, just to give our sea a little bit of depth. So I'm going to use brush number 2, so it's just a slightly slanted one. Okay, you can see that there. Again, dip in your water a little bit and get some of that nice dark colour. I'm just going to put it all along the horizon line. Just again, creates a little bit of depth. Kind of drag it forward a little bit. And you can add some into the middle of the sections as well. Just gives a bit of movement and light and shade. We'll actually try a little bit of the purple as well in there in the back. Bring it forward a little bit, just in kind of, not stripes exactly, but very rough kind of stripes. You can see there that it's given it a bit of shape. It's good to keep cleaning out your brushes and all that as well. I'll have a little bit of tissue there just to dry them off. Now I'm going to go back to brush number 2 again. And just with some of your white, you should have some left over. If you want to just get some of your plain white on a relatively dry brush, not too much water in this section. We're just going to add in a few clouds. So you just dab them in. Twist the brush around in different circles. They can be scattered all over the place. And you can just have a few on the sides if you want. It just gives a nice little bit of texture. And the same kind of on the other side. and just dabbing them in. And moving it all around. Hopefully you can see that there. Makes a big difference though, just that little bit. And you can keep going with that if you want. And sometimes your sky can look a little bit too light, so if you want, you can add in a little bit more of your blue, so the original blue that we were using. Could go in with some of that underneath. Underneath, and then just keep dabbing it in. Because again, that just gives a sense of shape and movement. So hopefully you can see that little bit there. I'll try that again. So I'll just add in a little bit here. Just keep dabbing it in. Take your time. And you can be alternating that with the white as well, if you want. Nice to just give it a go. Yeah, so that's obviously nice and simple. But you can do some other little bits, like adding some more highlights and stuff like that. You can add a few little white lines here. As the water would be coming in, some kind of sharper white lines, which I think make a nice difference. And just a few of them is fine. You can kind of drag the brush along it, it can be kind of random. I think they look pretty good. I'll clean off my brush, I'm using that really thin one again. And just with the dark brown colour that you should still have on your palette, we'll just do a few tiny little birds. So you just do like a tiny little M, a long M, or a little squiggle. I'm not sure if you can see those, they're quite tiny. I normally do three or four. I'll just hold that up for you, just so you can see. And then all you want to do, you can obviously add more to these. I'm just doing this quickly as a little tutorial. But just pop your initials down the bottom. And there you have it. Nice little beach scene. So hopefully that makes sense. If anyone has questions or anything, please let me know. Thanks very much.